Hey everybody, welcome back to another episode of Reaction Therapy. I am Tom Stevens, your resident psychotherapist, here to break down the lyrics to some awesome music. And today is truly awesome music because we are continuing the NF journey. Oh, this has been quite a journey. Number 23 today, I believe we're doing No Name. This, I think, is finishing up the Perception album. And then I think we go on to a new album after this. Y'all know way better than me. NF fans, let me know what you think. Apologize for, I kind of noticed in the camera, I look maybe like a priest today or something. I'm not meaning to look that way. I just love this cross. My wife got it for me for Valentine's Day, and I can't stop wearing it. So I am pumped. I'm ready. The NF journey continues. If you have not subscribed yet, please hit that subscribe button. You won't regret it. Great reactions coming out. A Patreon channel coming out soon with even more options for you to get more content than you've already had. Still be on YouTube, just not as much, and be over there at Patreon doing a whole lot more and contact with me. Discord channel, it's there. Look at the link in the description of this video and you can go join us, chat. I pop in there. We can talk. It's a cool thing to have. Everybody give me your feedback. I am so thankful. Thank you, everybody, so much for being a part of the Reaction Therapy family and for joining us every day we do this, because Nick and I are having a blast and it's so much fun. I am so thankful to you. In such a short time, we've grown so big and had so much fun, and it's a blast. So without further ado, let's continue the NF journey with No Name. Oh, man. Oh, gosh. Look, people ask me what the future. Oh, the shaky screen. It's there. He's coming hard at this, finishing up this Perception album. Like, I have a feeling he's going to be, you know, I feel like if I was against him or like putting him down or not believing in him, I would be beat up and bruised at this point because he just doesn't stop with any songs. I love NF. Oh, the chance to sit down and just chat with him and learn about his life and the story behind some of these stories, because he makes great videos, great music, and it's elevating every single song. I feel like it's getting better, more quality, everything. But he is coming at this, and I don't know what No Name is, but he's always said, you know, I'm just a regular guy. I'm just, and my people are regular people. And he doesn't have to be this big, blown up character. Here we go, the shaky screen. Look, people ask me what the future is. All I know is I'll be doing this. All I know is things are moving quick. That's convenient for me because that's how I live. Now they see me out here moving up. You don't like me, that makes two of us. Time change, yeah, I can't. You don't like me, that makes two of us. Here goes another 30-minute NF reaction, right? I'm so sorry, but I'm not sorry. Because, sorry, not sorry. Because these are so truthful. I feel that same way in my life. Like, this is what I do. Like, this is my life. I love my job every day. I get to go into work. I love getting to be able to talk to people, help people. It's not fun all the time. It can be hard and brutal and it can beat me up, but this is what I know how to do. And I love how he says, you don't like me, that makes two of us. Like, he's just honest with, I don't like myself all the time. Like, I can remember the things I've messed up. I can remember the things I don't do right. I can know the feelings I have, but he's getting them out here. And he's like, you're not going to hurt me by telling me you don't like me. That's not going to work here because I'm already there. This beat is insane. Now they see me out here moving up. You don't like me, that makes two of us. Time change, yeah, I can't adjust. Yo, it's who you are, not who you was. Yep. Yeah, just went to Europe. They say this single is working. I think I'm learning. I am way more than what people might think when they look on the surface. Yep. What is my purpose? Yeah, that is a question that I have been asking myself and it hurts. Cause probably something I should already know, but I don't know it yet. I'm trying to grow as a person. Oh man, his purpose. He's trying to grow as a person, but his purpose, he doesn't know what it is, but he feels like that's something I should already know. When you come in my office, that is one of the things I'm like, I'm going to hand you a notepad. I have these little Tom Stevens books. That's what I should send out to different people when we get the Patreon. These little Tom Stevens books with a pen and notepad, and you can take notes and people can bring it back into session with them. Take the notes of your life and bring them back to me. When you're trying to figure out what your purpose is, you don't look at who you were. You look at who you are. And the past has created who you are today. And if you want to be somebody different in the future, then we have to look at what you are today and how we can work with that to get you, just like Google Maps, or Waze or something, when you go somewhere, you want to go to this destination, you normally travel these roads, but it says, hey, you need to go this way because there's accident, construction, detour, all that stuff. And it tells you the best, quickest way to go. That's what therapy is. And he's saying, I'm trying to learn about myself and grow as a person. He goes to Europe, it blows up, and he all of a sudden is thrown into this life he has not seen before. And he's trying to adapt. And asking myself, and it hurts, because probably something I should already know, but I don't know it yet. I'm trying to grow as a person. Woo! I'm sick of people telling people I'm here because of marketing dollars. Mm-hmm. Oh, you think that everything is going to blow just because you marketed harder?
No.
I got my hands in everything. Not AI trying to get to me. Stop trying to lecture me. You don't compare to my level of thinking, so why do you think you compare to my energy? I can't even take all this in. Like, I cannot take all this in. And knowing, like I've said, I've heard music from NF because of my son Nick, who's co-creator of this whole thing, has loved NF from like since he was the beginning, honestly, first album, I think. And man, I've heard this music and I've heard it, and this is actually probably something I've had on a Spotify list or something and jogged to, but I don't know that I've sat down and listened to all these words, and there's too many. I can't take all of these words in, or I'd be sitting here, we're a minute in, and I need to hear this again. Gonna blow just because you marketed harder? No, I got my hands in everything. Not AI trying to get to me. Stop trying to lecture me. You don't compare to my level of thinking, so why do you think you compare to my energy? Yep. Small circle, but the numbers growing. Fame called me, I'm like, how you doing? Hung up on a mind, ready for it. I get back to that when I make album four. Fame calls. What a great way to say this. Fame calls, he hung up on him. Like, how you doing? And he hangs up on him. I'll get back to you when I make album four. Like, this isn't enough. Fame's not here yet. And he's not about the fame. But as he grows, the fame comes to him. And he's not paying attention to that. So he takes the negative energy, or the people that want to blow him up, or the people that, you know, want to market him. Yeah, he could probably be marketed harder and grow bigger. It's kind of like the 21 Pilots thing. I mean, people have told me that they always wanted to stay themselves. And somehow I think they also kind of ended up signing a big deal and being into the big machine of marketing and media. And it's hard when you're forced into this issue of you're growing bigger and bigger. What do you do? And he's fighting that battle. Call me, I'm like, how you doing? Hung up on a mind, ready for it. I get back to that when I make album four. Less talking, I've been working more. Better me is what I'm working towards. Mm-hmm. Y'all judging, but we not in court. No, we not in court. Last couple years, let's recap. All right, goes fast. All of a sudden, he starts going fast. Y'all judging, but we're not in court. Love this. Okay, now he's going faster. And I just want to hear this, and then I'll go back. Y'all judging, but we not in court. No, we not in court. Oh, Lord. Last couple years, let's recap. I make a living off of writing on my regrets. I'm doing me, I don't care where the scene's at. Try to give me feedback, I don't really need that. I used to walk on stage in a V-neck. I used to wear a little tie with a black vest. I came a long way, why you looking upset? I'm trying to paint a picture, get the vision, you ain't here yet. So much in that. I mean, he is laying it out like, I'm just going to tell you. In other words, he doesn't let you get a word in edgewise. Like, he is going to tell you what the story is, what the reality is, what's real, as he says, and he's going to put it out there. I caught the thing of, like, I make a living off of writing all my regrets. And what a great thing to do. Like, I tell people, journal, put it down. He happens to have amazing talent to do this. Great. And he can take his life, put it out there, and make a living off of it because other people relate to it. Okay, I want to go back to this because he did such a good job here. More better me is what I'm working towards. Y'all judging, but we not in court. No, we not in court. Oh, Lord. Last couple years, let's recap. I make a living off of writing on my regrets. I'm doing me. I don't care where the scene's at. Try to give me feedback. I don't really need that. I used to walk on stage in a V-neck. I used to wear a little tie with a black.
I wonder when he did. Is there a video out there of him walking on stage with a V-neck and his tie and trying to sing? Because there had to be pieces of him way back when he wasn't who he is today, and he used to be this guy, and you know, he evolves over time, he becomes who he is, his image, his character. Probably going to be defined myself by the vests I wear and these sweaters that I wear, right? Because it seems like that's all I do, but I'm an older guy, and that's what we do as we age. He does a great job of breaking all this down. Give me feedback, I don't really need that. I used to walk on stage in a V-neck. I used to wear a little tie with a black vest. I came a long way. Why are you looking upset? I'm trying to paint a picture, get the vision, you ain't here yet. Why are you upset? I'm just painting a picture and get a vision. Give you a vision of what it's like.
Look, hold up, wait a minute, please. Flow switching, I got ADD.
I'm the same way. ADD in the brain with me. I am scattered. I'm all over the place. And he's switching every 30 seconds. It's switching. All of a sudden, it slows back down, which I appreciate. But man, this is hype.
Look, hold up, wait a minute, please. Flow switching, I got ADD. Brain scatters when you play the beat. It don't matter what you say to me. I'll be doing this at 83. I've been doing this since ABCs in the major leagues doing...
Man, did you hear that? I'll be doing this till 83. I guess till he's 83. Like forever, basically. And he's been doing it since ABCs, like his whole life. This is what he does. I feel the same way with me. This is what I'll be doing. And doing these reactions has been awesome because it's like a supplement for me. I could talk to so many more people. I can share so many of the ideas I have until I can get this book out that I've been trying to write with my ADD for years that just isn't happening. But to get what I know out and have people hear it, and then also meet people and talk to people and doing it forever. I've been doing this 25 years. I don't mind doing it 25 more years because it's so fun and he's having a blast.
I'll be doing this at 83. I've been doing this since ABCs in the major leagues, doing major things. Don't play with me.
I'm living life in
the fast lane. Wake up every morning thinking I might have a bad day. Drive my own car. I don't like the valet. Park, then I go into my mind with an AK.
Drive my car. I don't like to valet. Like, I love that. Y'all probably don't even know this about me. I don't even have a car anymore. Honestly, my wife has a car. My two sons have a car. I don't have a car. I finally said, that's enough. I don't need a car. I live 4 miles from my work. I got an electric bike. I have an e-bike, y'all. And I ride that to work. I love it. It's the best thing ever. To simplify things, I am just me. If you see me at a restaurant, I am just Tom. And I can't wait for the day I get to see one of y'all at a restaurant or out somewhere because I want to see people. I like to talk to people. And he's saying, I stay simple. This is just me. I don't know where the AK thing is coming in, where he's starting to blow people away, but I want to hear this.
Thinking I might have a bad day. Drive my own car. I don't like the valet. Park, then I go into my mind with an AK. Shoot every thought in my head, then it rotates. Losing it all, but I think that I'm okay. Who was involved? I don't know, but I'm insane. Poof, and I'm...
Man. So he's shooting the thoughts in his head. Like, he's got so many conflicting thoughts of negativity, of fear, of what could go wrong, of why he doesn't deserve. And he's got a lot, and he's trying to battle those in his mind. And that's where the AK comes in. It takes an AK to probably blow those away.
And then it rotates. Losing it all, but I think that I'm okay. Who was involved? I don't know, but I'm insane. Poof, and I'm gone. Wanna call me a no-name? What?
There it is. Call me a no-name. You wanna call me a no-name? What? And then the screen shakes again. Love the screen shake.
I'm okay. Who was involved? I don't know, but I'm insane. Poof, and I'm gone. Wanna call me a no-name? What? I'm probably not what you thought.
Yep.
I used to judge everybody that wasn't like me till I learned it was wrong.
That's me. Man, this is such a long video. I am loving this. Y'all got all day to spend with me? I would love that. That's me. Judgment, I've said to people for years, judgment is my biggest character flaw. If I'm going to name one, it's going to be that. I get judgy. It's all out of insecurity, right? But I get judgy and I got to watch that. If I don't talk about it, it's going to take over. So I talk about the things that I am insecure about or that are vulnerabilities because it keeps me from doing it. So the more I talk about being judgy and the way I am, the less I actually do it. And he's saying that. I used to judge everybody. And till I learned it was wrong. And that's me. I learned it was wrong. And so I put it out there. And if I'm going to have a character defect, it's going to be that. And I want that to be known by people because I want them to know that that's not what I'm here for. And I've grown and I've gotten through a lot of therapy. I've gone through a lot of help and growth and maturity. And I think it's helped because I don't have to judge people anymore. I really don't. And he's saying that. I've moved past that. It's not me anymore.
I'm probably not what you thought. I used to judge everybody that wasn't like me till I learned it was wrong. Girl told me I should get it together and get out the dark. I'm trying to give her my heart. That's when I sit in my car, writing for hours until I can barely talk. I mean, where do I start? Feels like I'm falling apart. Act like my image is hard. I always put on my guard.
Man, acting my image is hard. Like he's talking about, I'm trying to have a relationship. Girl's telling him, man, you gotta open up. You gotta do this. And he's like, writing. He could get it all out on paper, but it's hard to do it face to face in a relationship with somebody. That's hard. And he is talking about it. And that's the key. Talk about your vulnerabilities, your insecurities when it's safe, but talk about them because that way you can work with them. What's mentionable is manageable. You can do something about it. And he, oh my gosh, this is so good.
Where do I start? Feels like I'm falling apart. Act like my image is hard. Yep. I always put on my guard. Even when talking to God, sit in my room and I plot. Everything that I'm not comes out in the music I try.
You You know, he does have a tough image. He has a hard image as far as like, I'm this tough, but really inside, it's the frailty, it's the vulnerability. Like, I'm just a regular guy, but I have to be this. Sometimes he's conflicted, I think.
When talking to God, sit in my room and I plot. Everything that I'm not comes out in the music I tried. I give it all that I got. I give it all.
Man, so talking to God and putting everything out there, just leaving it all out on the stage and just trying his best to be who he can be and pouring everything out, which is what Nick and I do with this.
Everything that I'm not comes out in the music I tried. I give it all that I got. I give it all that I got. I'm trying to think of the box, no.
Yeah, I got people standing outside a bus screaming my name.
Now he does a whole nother flow. Like, all of a sudden everything goes down to just piano. And he's talking now, just talking about it. And he's talking about a bus, people screaming his name. I can't imagine what it's like to have insecurities or to be, like, I'm a total introvert, even though you wouldn't know that seeing it here. But if you see me at a party, I'll sit off to the side and hang by myself. I don't have to be engaged with people all the time. And he's probably saying, I love doing this, but it's overwhelming seeing all these people. I can't please all these people. I can't say hi to all these people. And I feel, I was watching the Billie Eilish documentary thing, and I remember her just wanting to be away because it's just too much. And it's overwhelming. And sometimes it's everybody else's need and not his.
I'm trying to think of the box, no!
Yeah, I got people standing outside a bus screaming my name. I don't come out and take pictures, they tell me I change. I don't smile at VIPs, you get mad like you know what I paid. Guess I don't know what to say. Guess I don't know what to say.
Man, people pay to see him. People pay to go backstage to see him. And you know what they want? They want the engaged, interactive, great to see you NF. But you know what? That's hundreds or thousands of people that all want that same attention. And it's very hard to give that, because people just want to talk to you. I remember giving this keynote talk a couple of years ago, and there was 1,000 people in the room, and it was a good talk. It was a fun talk, and it was an inspirational talk about raising children and the life of children. And I had a line full of people afterwards coming up to talk to me, and I love talking to them, and each one wanted to talk to me. And it probably took another hour just to go off to the side and talk to each person, because I don't like to just rush through it. But it's exhausting to do that. And I think he's saying, you know, sometimes it's not that I try to be avoid it, but it is overwhelming and exhausting, and I'm touring, I'm all over the place, and it's hard. And that people just need to understand that, I think.
I'm smiling VIPs, you get mad like you know what I paid. Guess I don't know what to say. Guess I don't know what to say. I leave it all on the stage. I leave it all on the stage.
Facts. I was hanging on till the end with that one, y'all, because people have told me with NF, sometimes things pop in at the last second that you might miss if you don't watch the entire end of the video. But that's looks like it just faded out with him walking away. And what a great piece of lyric to end at the end, right? I leave it all on the stage. I leave it all on the stage. Like, I don't know what to say. Like, this is, I just do the best I can. I tell people that here at Reaction Therapy, because we can't please everybody with requests and with things they want to hear or see. And we try our best, but we put everything into every video we have, with Nick editing and setting up the schedule, with me doing this and reacting. Thank you so much for taking a piece of your afternoon to watch this. NF fans, let me know what you think. Give me your insight and feedback on this video. And everybody else, please share with me. How's it going? How's your day? Let me know how it's going. I just love seeing y'all and hearing from you. Go to the Discord channel. Sometimes I'll pop in there and talk to you too. There's a great family growing there day after day. And if you haven't subscribed, please do that now. You won't regret it. Remember, this isn't real therapy. This is just Tom talking about the lyrics of the music, which I love to do. But if you want real help, go to the link in our bio. Got some resources there that can help you find some real help. And you deserve that. Everybody does. Thanks for being here. And I cannot wait to see you on the next Reaction Therapy.